I'm currently working on my filament test series, which makes me print several exotic materials that aren't as easy to handle as PLA. Many of these, like nylon, polycarbonate or TPU, need to be stored really dry that they don't absorb moisture. Today, I'll be showing you how I build a simple and cheap filament dry box, which you can use to store your filaments and even directly print out of. Guten Tag everybody, I'm Stefan and welcome to CNC Kitchen. Moisture is a major concern when it comes to 3D printing, because working with dry filament makes the difference between a successful print and a lot of problems. I gotta be honest, but I store most of my PLA filaments on a holder here in my office and don't really have an issue with these so far, because once, PLA isn't printed as hot, and second, it doesn't absorb moisture that quickly. But as soon as you get into more uncommon materials, the storage location can become an issue. I store my ABS and PETG filaments in a box where I added a couple of these nylon bags filled with silica gel. When I use a spool, I just take it out of the box and then put it on the normal spool holder of my printers, and that works totally fine. I'm getting more and more into printing nylons and polycarbonate. For most of these, it's essential to keep them dry even during printing, because even a day out in normal ambient air might result in a print that is more foam in the end instead of solid plastic. Also, PVA, the water-soluble support material, is very susceptible to moisture, and even though it might be printing well for a while, your print results will improve if you keep it dry all the time. Due to these reasons, I built myself an easy filament dry box I can use to store my most critical materials and even attach a Bowden tube to it to directly print out of the box. We only need a few simple things, which are a plastic container which is big enough to hold a couple of rolls of filament and a bunch of silica gel pearls. These can be purchased on Amazon or eBay in larger quantities. This is pretty much the same stuff that is also in the silica gel packages you will know, but the pearls contain an indicator that turns green as soon as they get saturated with water. A kilo is plenty for a box of 3 rolls. The nice thing is that you can reuse it as much as you like. Once you see that the moisture level in your box doesn't go down as far anymore and the silica gel pearls change color, you put everything on a baking tray and put it into your oven at around 110 degrees Celsius and open the door from time to time to remove the moist air from the oven. After around an hour, the pearls are dry again and change their color back to orange. Just leave them in the oven until they are almost cooled down and then put them back into the box. If anybody wonders, I also tried using silica cat litter, which didn't work for me at all. Maybe I would have needed to dry it before. I wouldn't recommend that you only use bags of silica gel that you gathered from your filament packs, because the amount of material they contain is so little that they will hardly last for a longer period of time. And since you can't judge if they are still okay or not, it's hard to tell if they're still working. This brings me to the next item on the list. I have one of these cheap hygrometers in all of my filament boxes to check the environmental conditions. This is nice for the big box where I don't directly see the silica gel, but I also noticed that the moisture level will rise already when the silica gel just started to change its color. Then we will need a piece of PVC tube which holds the spools and two 3D printed holders. If your tube diameter doesn't match mine, just scale the model accordingly. Then we need a Teflon tube that is used to guide the filament from the box to the printhead, so it has no chance to pick up any moisture. In order to connect these to the box, I used commercially available Bowden connectors, but you can also print one out on your own. You can find links to all of these items down in the description. Start by grabbing the biggest roll you want to add to your box and mark the location where the tube needs to be. I didn't center the holder because this will result in a straighter filament path with different roll sizes and amount of material that is still left. Now take your bracket and mark the locations where you will need to drill. I use the wood drill since with its tip it's way easier to start a hole within the plastic. Then also drill a hole in the right size where the Bowden connector shall go later. I drill two holes in the upper part of the box so that I can use the second hole later for the storing position. Now just bolt the bracket to the box. If you want to be extra thorough, you can add a foam seal to the lid, but the amount of silica gel that is in the box can easily handle small leakages over a longer period of time. Make sure that your box has some kind of clips to close the lid properly. When I bought mine at IKEA, the clips were out of stock, so I just printed a couple. Pour in a bunch of silica gel and you're all set. Now you can simply add your precious rolls of filament to the box and store them in there very dry. Mine goes down to below 10% in a couple of hours and dries out bad filament only in a matter of days. Even though the silica gel pearls look clean, I was able to spot some dust after adding them to the box. Since you don't want that in your nozzle, just add one of these universal filament dust cleaners inside of the box. When I don't use the box, I close the connectors with specifically designed plugs, but you can also just use two small pieces of Teflon tube, which you seal at one end. Before starting a print, slide the material through the Bowden tube and feed it into your printer just as normal. Make sure that you don't have too much drag, and if so, check the Bowden tube and the dust filter. Also make sure that the Bowden tube is long enough and maybe even guided somehow, that it doesn't interfere with your print. When I'm done printing, I either remove the Bowden tube or I just feed the end into the second connector so that I can easily load it the next time without needing to open the box.
That's it! This is a very convenient solution for me now if I want to print nylon, PVA or similar. Even drying bad filament with this box works great! You can find links to all of the items you need down below. If you enjoyed the video, then please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel and consider supporting me on Patreon. Take a look at the other videos on my channel if you want to learn more about 3D printing. Thanks for watching, auf Wiedersehen, and I'll see you next time!